we doing today?
Jay Shrek.
And James.
And so what happened was we were foiled.
We were.
By bald eagles. So we're heading up to Indian Mesa, and it says that the area is closed for 6 months. For, I guess they, you know, they got a lounge, they got a bald eagle lounge, and they hang out and they mate. So we got jacked on that. We were going to Sedona, it's raining.
Get okay? All the clouds.
Then we're like, what's next? We'll go to Agua Fria, we'll go to Brooklyn. We're like, well, you can't be up there when it's raining.
Not so, getting out of that.
So I guess the point really is, you know, when you do this, I mean, you never know what's going to happen, right? I mean, you...
No, that's part of what you got to be in store for is, you know, this isn't like going to the mall. Things will happen. Weather will intervene.
So here's what's funny is we see this guy walking through and he looks like the real deal. He's like an adventurer that's like a real adventurer, right? He's got the pack. He's got the beard. He is trucking.
I would say full on leather tramp.
So he says, it's beautiful down here. And he says, you go one of two ways. You get to the top of the hill, you go right, it goes to the Mary Kay mine. You go left, it goes to the river. So I think what we'll do, James, is let's just take a freestyle today and let's just see where it goes, right? Let's see where we end up. Let's try to go to the mine. How's that sound?
I say we go check out a mine today. That's a good thing to do.
So we're at Black Canyon City.
Black Canyon Trailhead. Off we go.
Yesterday, but
there's a little foot version.
This must be for bikes.
Yep, exactly.
That is a bad boy right there. When the arms are as big as the trunk or bigger than the trunk, you got a real deal.
Here's some healthy saguaro.
Some of the healthiest we've come across.
Really good stuff, man.
I mean, look at the girth. Okay, isn't it amazing how you get down into a valley? You get up on a mountain, you look down the valley, and man.
That's quite a view.
So, you know, anywhere there's water like this, you would think particularly there could be a possibility of some type of natives. You know, even though a gentleman we talked to said that he didn't know of any.
He didn't know of any, like, petroglyphs or any remnants. But, I mean, we can definitely assume that this was an area.
We're told it's a Mary Kay mine. But here, look at this, James. I got a question, okay? Why would they care if you have an e-bike? Why would that even be an issue that you had an e-bike? It doesn't make any sense to me. And we're not riding, so it's not like we care that. I mean, I don't have an e-bike and I'm mad because I don't get to ride it. I just don't see why a person with an e-bike couldn't ride this trail. I don't see what, you know, is an e-bike gonna tear it up more? Hell no, it isn't. Isn't this awesome? Group of people down there took the lower trail while we hustled the higher trail. Looks like it comes around.
Yeah.
And then back down over here.
Switches back up.
Yeah. Like that, you'd be riding bikes like that. You'd be looking like you're smuggling grapes or coconuts. I'm not trying to get into that business. But you'd be...
To fill you in, he's trying to convince you how you become like a spandex wearing biker right now.
And then you wear them little plastic shoes and you go into Circle K, click, click, click with your bike because you don't want to leave it outside because people are going to steal it. So you got your bike, you spent $8 million on, you saved about 18 ounces. It cost you $10,000, but you could have just not ate some Twinkies, and then you wouldn't have to worry about it. And then you go Circle K, like, click, click, click.
I'm alarmed how much you thought about
click,
this. It's
click, 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 click. Stay out of my way, cars. I'm in my lane. Not that I have an opinion
no,
on that.
You have
or I've even business, that I've even thought about it. Yeah, there they are. They're running.
There's some javeliner.
See, I want to see. Oh, there's the third one. The big one.
Yeah, he's now the tail end. They heard us and took off.
Now the big one's always in the back, monitoring from behind. So it's crazy that it sounds. They're not out front, they're actually behind.
Yeah.
Wow, look at that. That's beautiful.
It is gorgeous.
Now, when I was doing some research on Extreme Mesa over there, I saw a house in the middle of nowhere that was one of these. I couldn't even believe what I was seeing. I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, that's the affluent folk of Black Canyon City.
You know, I don't, you know, everybody's got their own vision, you know, and what happens in this world is we put ourselves behind the eight ball, and it doesn't allow us to do what we want to do, and it forces us to spend a lot of time in places we don't want to be, waiting for that magical time that I get to not do that. And the problem with that is the thing that's limited is your physicality. So finally you get there, you get to a point where you don't have to work, and then what happens?
Because
you physically can't.
Yeah, I'm going to call that guy one of the richest people I've ever met.
And then you go, and your only option for entertainment is watch TV and drink.
Yeah.
And that ain't...
That's not what I want to do.
That's
what you dig right on, man. As we would say, none of my business, but yeah. I do have an opinion on it.
There's like three claims, and I don't understand all of them, but a lot of them, you can still go in, and you can go hang out and do whatever you want to do. You just can't take anything out of there. So it's not like because we see this here, we can't go in. It just basically means that...
The mineral rights.
Yeah, you can't take anything out of there, but you can go in.
Well, we're cruising through. It takes you across the river as we were debating what it would do with us here. We didn't really look at the map at the trailhead, to be honest.
Maps? We don't need no stinking maps.
Since we didn't really bargain for... this hike, it might actually get fairly deep in there, because that's still water.
They say still water runs deep, James.
That's exactly what they say. That's what I do know from experience. I might have to actually swim part of that.
That is a wide...
That's a real river. You don't see that every day.
Now, here's what's funny is I thought that water over there was running that way, but this is another. So this is not the same. Maybe is that one over there? Maybe they come together?
This could be part of the tributary that, or they split and then meet. I'm sure it's been diverted off of where that town is now too at some point. But that's deep, look at that dude. Even right there, it's pretty deep.
Well, now we're fish.
That's deep.
Shit, yeah, that's like, you know, it's over your head deep right there.
Yeah, that would definitely go over my head. That's wild, dude.
Okay, everybody. I think James needs to go swimming. He needs to see how deep this is. That'd be awesome to jump off of that. Now, it looks like it's deeper in these pools. You know, one of the things that I miss about the Midwest is I miss the water. You know, you don't have as much water here. So you get into Arizona and you see places like this, and man, how cool is this? And you're looking on the sand and you can see every animal, and there's a large quantity of animals that are through here. We're seeing all kinds of footprints from probably badgers, raccoons, probably a little bit of everything. But when you see this, the beauty of Arizona, you know, you just think of, well, let's look at those cactus right back up here, right? So there's our cactus, but then the opposite of the cactus, when you think of that, is a beautiful stream like this. And I wanted James to go swimming, and I'm not convincing him because I want him to jump off that rock right there, because I think that would be awesome. But I don't think he's going to do it.
We'll come back, not in January. Jeff doesn't want to deal with me hypothermic.
I could carry you out of here, James. Today I could. So you better pick today, the day that I can do it.
Okay.
So if you're wanting to get out there, I see bike tracks all through here.
Yeah, someone definitely came through. I saw someone was walking through here barefoot.
Okay, there's where you cross if you want to get over.
You need to get over, yeah.
This was a local hangout and or the mine.
Well, I mean, exactly.
They drove to the mine. Because this was a road.
Yeah, exactly.
But, you know, back in the day, people didn't care about, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
They did whatever they wanted to.
I'm sure if you were able to sift through this long enough, you'd definitely find yourself an arrowhead.
Oh, they were definitely all through here. What great hunting grounds this would have been. Now, this wasn't our trail. That definitely is a trail.
That's a trail. That'll take us up. We're further down this way from where we jumped down.
I'd be curious to see where that, because that's a well-worn trail,
yeah,
though.
That'll cut up.
I'm just curious where if it's going to cross into that. Look at James. He's eating all kinds of shit. See, what happened was for Christmas, he got food, trail food. So he was eating this like trail crap. Let's call it that with a K, K-R-A-P. And then Christmas came and Santa came down the chimney and Santa had a whole bag of treats. So
oh, yeah.
He's living large right now. He is eating all kinds of stuff on the trail. So there's where we came from. We you can see the trail right across there if you look real good. So we traversed down that. That cliff face is beautiful. Really nice high-end houses there. What a beautiful area. And there's some mines over there. Looks like there's some mines back up in there. We didn't decide to cross the creek today, but I'm telling you what. This is a beautiful place. And again, look at that cactus right there. Look at that sucker. Isn't that beautiful? Look at them clouds moving. And there's the clouds coming in. We know we got weather coming this way. So we're probably going to hike out of here, but man, what a beautiful day this was. Right, James?
Oh, dude, this is a great little trip. I would definitely come back here.
You know, the cool thing about Arizona is that if you're, you know, we hike South Mountain because it's more of a training. But, you know, you could hike a new trail every day, probably the rest of your life. Even in South Mountain, there's hundreds of trails. I say hundreds, probably not that many, but a lot. And
on that one side.
You know, so this is really cool. We get to come out here and do this today. And you know, you always hope, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I'd like to found some type of petroglyphs or something out here, but man, it's still a beautiful day. And he's not hating, and he's got a whole bag of food. It's unbelievable. And he didn't have to work, so he got to come out again today.
Yeah.
So.
That's a good thing, for sure.
That's always a good day when James ain't got a.
I'm pretty lucky. I only got to work 2 days a week, but, you know, it is nice to get out here.
Hey, Jay Shrek, you know, we're out on the trail, and we found a fellow hiker out here. What's your name?
Ken.
Ken, you've got a YouTube channel also, right?
Just starting one.
What's the name of it?
Arizona Walkabout.
Cool. So what's your, I mean, yeah, it sounds like you're going to walk around Arizona, but do you have like a plan that you're doing, and what's your game plan?
Well, my game plan is I got another show I'm doing called Old Gold of the Great Southwest. So
okay.
Arizona Walkabout is just like my prelude.
Okay.
I've been
okay.
working on Old Gold for about two years now.
Okay.
So, you know, they said when you could do YouTube, just do it.
Right.
So that's what I'm doing. I've just started out. I make a lot of mistakes. Right, you know, I right, bumble around right. a lot, but I'm just doing it, you know.
So you come out and you've got a camp out here, right?
Yeah.
So you move around, is that, and then they come get you at a certain amount of time, or, you know, what's your, how are you working it?
I did 21 days. I think
okay.
I did 20 days up on Aquafina National Wilderness.
Okay.
And then I took 3 weeks off, and I came out here for 21 days.
Okay.
And I don't stay in place for more than 3 days. I don't
okay.
like to impact an area
right,
that much.
Right, right,
you know, but I do a little gold panning, too.
Right, right.
I've got the bug bad.
Okay.
Always have. I mean, you
know.
You know,
we do the, we're doing the, all the Dutchmen. Part of our show is we do the Dutchmen one episode, and then we do everywhere else the other episode. So one right. on Monday and one on Thursday.
Nice.
So we do the same kind of, you know, we're not. Yeah. We just love the myths and the legends and all that stuff of Arizona. We just think
exactly.
that's neat, right?
Exactly.
It's awesome to see you out here, man.
What's name? Now, what's your show?
We're Black Flag Expedition.
Black Flag Expedition.
Yeah.
Check that
yeah.
out.
Yeah. And so you'll find us under Ed Psychotic. I'll give you, we got a card,
we
don't we,
do
James?
We have cards now.
Right, I'll give you a card and subscribe to us and we'll subscribe to you. Well, what a day today was. You know, we met a new friend on the trail. We had a great day. James is able to not be a prisoner to work. He's able to come out and have fun with us again today like it's supposed to be. And we saw a beautiful area. And you know, Arizona is just a fabulous place. There's nothing like this state anywhere. And Black Canyon Trail ended up being a great one, didn't it, James?
It did. This is a good
so, you, what are you going to give me, a 5 stars?
Yeah, Yeah, five today for sure.
You know, good water, cool stream, and you know, pretty quick, great trail, very doable, very usable, really nice transitions, and it definitely was a hike I needed today to get going. You know, if you like this content, please like, please subscribe, and what's the third thing, James?
Hit that notification button.
Because it not only tells you that you love us, as soon as we put any content out there, it lets you know. One thing also is that if you know some cool places, or there's some places that you would like to see us go, then...
send us a comment.
Yeah, send us a comment. We also have Black Flag Expedition, which is our
Facebook
page. We have also an Instagram, and then James has a James Out In It Instagram also.
Check that out.
If you'd like to check that out and see his doings when he's out and about, out in it, that's awesome. So have a great day today. It's been a great day, hasn't it?
Yeah, this is a really good day, man. I would definitely put this on a you should hike this trail.
But we are going to get it back into Sedona, and we're going to tear Sedona up. So I can't wait for that either, but which one today? Cool, let's get out of here.
All right, let's keep rolling.